Hello everyone, in this video let's have a look at the Miku UI ROM for the LG V30. So it has the April security patch level as of now. As you can see here, this is the home screen and there aren't really much settings here to customize, but it is pretty clean, so that is something going for it. Please note that this ROM does not come with Google apps, so you will have to separately flash them. And here are the quick tiles, as you can see here, and use Google apps which come with the setup wizard. So basically the Google setup wizard that you have at the beginning, because by default this ROM ships with a different language. I think it is Chinese, so you may end up with issues switching to English if you do not have the Google setup initially. And it also has the Hive Attack settings. Please note that VoLTE and VO Wi-Fi do not work on this ROM. And here's the display section. As you can see here, let's turn on the dark theme. Okay, so let's move in further. As you can see here, there is double tap to wake option. And nothing much apart from that, but here you'll find the always on display under a new name that is always show messages, etc., whatever. So turn that on if you like always on display. Let's see what else we have here. As you can see here in the security settings, we do not have face unlock in this particular ROM, but there is smart unlock, so that will have to do. Let's move in further. Under the system options, we do have some options like gestures. And you can quickly open the camera using this, and you also have the system navigation bar options, as you can see here. So this is a pretty bare bone ROMs with minimal customization, but it is pretty smooth, so that is something it has going for it. And as you can see here, you can customize the sensitivity on the left and right edge, and you also have option to swipe for assistant, but I have disabled that. And let's go in further, and we have the one-handed mode here. I do not really use it, so I'll probably turn it off, but let me just show you quickly how it actually looks. You can get a pretty good idea from the animation, but I still showed you. And at the bottom you'll find there's also an option for enabling the one-handed mode if you often use that. So if you just tap on it, you'll have a button hanging around here using which you can turn on the one-handed mode. So it could come in handy for people who use it. And you have the option for double tap to sleep here as well, and swipe to screenshot. And those are pretty some useful features and I really like them. So let's turn them on and let's move in further and see what kind of other stuff we have hidden away here. So you have the Miku No Secret stuff, and here are the network traffic monitors. And I really like this because I like to see at what speed my Google apps or a new custom ROM is downloading. And as you can see here, there are custom icons on the top. And here I'm just messing around to see if anything else changes, but I don't really notice any change as such by messing around with these settings. So let me know in the comments in case I'm missing something, because I did not really notice any particular difference there. And here you can customize at what threshold it should show the network speed. And you also have this Miku media notification option as well. So that is pretty unique stuff here. And this is the icon pack, and I really like this. You can customize it here. As you can see here, you can change stuff up here. And it will change. So here's the icon shape changer. So let's tap on that and see what other stuff we have hidden away. And also let's change it to something more noticeable here. So as you can see here, the Wi-Fi icon has changed. And as you can see here, the icon pack has changed to the heart button. So do click on the like button and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Bye bye now.